Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 4 of Project Infinity. Today I am joined with a person you should all know by now for a very long time, which is my buddy, Yudeldor.
What's up, Corianche?
Hi there.
Hey.
So today, I got myself a lot of cool stuff planned involving fancy magic stuff. And you might be thinking, oh no, he's going to do the boring Towncraft stuff again, and or... But then, yeah, I don't know, we all know that, like, basic flowers and, you know, arcane stuff. Don't bother, I'm gonna click away. No, stay here, because I'm going to do a mod that I haven't played with in ages, which is Witchery. Yes, Witchery, you heard that right. It's been over, I'd say, almost 1.5 to 2 years ever since I've played with Witchery, and I've heard quite a lot of stuff has changed. Like, the last time I played, there wasn't even things like werewolves and, vampires and such. So, yeah, going to be awesome. So, I don't know if there's something I need to make before I can get started. I think the Witchcraft Collecting Fumes book would be a good start, which requires a Belladonna flower. So, let's see if we have that. So, Yudeldor, what are you up to today?
I'm just explaining... Or exploring some of the terrain, finding beehives, because we're going to start doing the forestry stuff.
Awesome.
Yeah, found a few already, but they're pretty rare.
Uh-huh. So, apparently we have all the witchery things besides the actual flower that I need.
Oh.
You will always see that. Belladonna. Nice. Let's see. Do I have any of them, any of these chests around here? I don't. Too short, maybe? No. And you know what that means, folks? It's time for me to actually get this flower. Because there is a chance you get it from grass, and you can also mutate it, but I'm too lazy to mutate it, so that's not what I'm going to do. So, let's go do some searching, and I will be right back. And we're back. So I collected myself the things that I needed to make the Collecting Fumes book. And remember when I said that I hopefully am not going to need to crossbreed the flowers to get myself the Belladonna flower? Yeah, I actually had to do that because for some reason they are extremely rare or my luck just sucks. Maybe both. So yeah, let's see. Witchcraft. Oh wait, I need a piece of charcoal too. Almost forgot about that. So, piece of charcoal, a piece book right there, a feather, an insect, and a Belladonna flower gives me the Collecting Fumes book.
Hooray!
Woohoo! Witchcraft, Collecting Fumes. The witch's oven gives a practitioner of the art the opportunity to collect the fumes that may be produced when cooking. Awesome stuff. Doesn't really say anything else, but so let's see what I need to make. Witchery. I need another distillery, not yet at least. I need a witch's oven, which is just a buttload of iron. And luckily, that is not something we have issues of, as is. So, let's see.
Wood.
No, iron, not wood.
No, wood.
Wood. Witch's oven. Crap. Some sort of recipe stuff going wrong. My client's having a different recipe than the server. I can't craft a witch's oven. One sec, guys. Alright, so, Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. So, stop derping. So I just created myself the witch's oven. Some issue with the server client-side stuff, so I had to delete the items and spawn it in for some reason. With this, I probably also want to make myself a fume funnel, which requires 4 empty buckets, a lava bucket, and just a buttload more iron, which is, you know, I need to keep an eye on it, that we don't actually run out of iron, because that would be not so good.
Yeah, we shouldn't.
Nah. Piece of glowstone. I need 1, 2, 3 buckets. Oops, I forgot that buckets now require you to actually make the metal former thingy. So 9 of those. 1 of these. and a bucket of lava. One lava, just stealing it from our smeltery. Sorry, Deldor.
No!
One iron bar, glowstone, and now I need to wait for these three buckets. Yeah, I'll be right back. And I got the iron plates done, so let's see, put them together like so. Got myself three more buckets. There we go, one fume funnel. And you get one of the five buckets back. That's weird that you don't get like all of them back. So I guess I can just put it in here for now, and then perhaps later I will be able to move them. So right there with the witch's oven and a fume funnel on top of it. Awesome. So this thing requires a couple of things. As you can see on the recipes, it requires you to have some clay jars, of course. A fuel source, which of course it's an oven, and some materials to smelt. And depending on the material that you want to smelt, you can get different types of, well, fumes collected in these clay jars. So these clay jars are just made with clay, yeah, a bunch of clay that you have to smelt. So let me quickly run back and get some. There is some clay in there for some reason. I think that, you know, should be enough for now. Oh, yeah, we have way more than enough clay, actually. No need to worry. Can this be smelted in a redstone furnace? It can! Woohoo! So let's see, what do I need for the next progression that mod that I want? For blood magic, you need the blood altar, which now requires the whiff of magic. An attuned stone, which requires a whiff of magic. You get a whiff of magic from a rowan wood sapling, or by distilling Breath of the Goddess, but I don't have a distillery yet, so that will have to wait for later. So, a rowan sapling. I have no idea how you can make that. I believe it used to be with some sort of transmutation powder on a sapling. Mutandis. Makes sense. Which is a mandrake root, an egg, and exhale of the horned one in a witch's cauldron, which is oak saplings. And that is something I am able to provide. So, a stack of oak saplings, some coal, and some of those fumes, or clay jars. So, you still searching for some fancy bees, I guess?
I think I found most of them, currently heading back, but I went quite far, so it's Ooh. Taking a while.
I can imagine. Oh, yeah, there we go. And witch's oven seems to be doing its thing. So let's see. I also needed a witch's cauldron, which apparently does not have a recipe. Why nice. Does that not have a recipe? Brews and infusions, which requires a odor of purity, which requires a hearthorn sapling, which requires stuff that I don't have. Wait, what? So I need an odor of purity, which requires a hawthorn sapling or a oil of vitriol. And the oil of vitriol I can make in a distillery. So how does one make a distillery? Distillery, which requires an attuned stone and the... I think I'm kind of going in a loop right here, as I need the witch's oven and a book, and I don't... What? This stuff makes no sense! Seriously, who thought of all these recipes?
What's going on?
You need one thing to make the other. Like, I need to make the witchcraft brews and infusions book, which requires the odor of purity as an ingredient. Which you can get in a witch's oven or a distillery. Well, the witch's oven is an option because I need a sapling that you can only get with the material that I'm actually trying to make with the mutandis, which I actually need to make with the odor of purity.
Right.
I can also use a distillery with the oil of vitriol. But the oil of vitriol requires a distillery. And a distillery requires the whiff of magic that you need to make in a witch's oven. Which requires a rowan sapling, which requires the mutandis. So I'm sitting here like, what on earth do I need to do? besides A shooting this.
Yeah, A requires B and B requires A.
Yeah, precisely. So I have absolutely no idea how I'm going to do this.
There's got to be a third way, right? Or is it just like messed up recipes?
I mean, I guess so. The Witch's Cauldron doesn't have an AI as recipe, so I'm not sure if there's like any other way of getting this. Like, I don't assume it's like a Towncraft research, because that would be extremely strange. So, I mean, actually, it could be part of the Essentia Distillation thing, as it like, distillation, perhaps? Like, maybe I'm going way too far thinking this through, but I've seen how some of the recipes really rely on another magic mod, so
honestly, yeah,
it could be a thing.
Yeah, some of the recipes in this pack are just like
crazy.
Yeah, crazy.
Yeah, precisely. Oh. So let me quickly look up what I need to do in this situation, and I will be right back. Alright, after doing quite a bit of research, I found out that there's a reason why this thing doesn't have a normal recipe, because it's something you do like an in-game recipe. So, first of all, what I need is a normal cauldron. And I need to get myself some mystical mana petals. Which I should be able to get quite easily from my Britannia setup. There we go. Also, I had to crossbreed one more pair of flowers. Because for this thing that I want to make, I need some anointing paste. Which requires one of each witchery seed. 4 cyan mana petals and a water bottle. And that's actually the only thing that's currently missing, which is the water bottle. And I believe we have some bottles around here. So that's pretty cool. Also, Swans has joined us on the server and on TeamSpeak, though he is not able to talk, but he is still able to listen. And he's saying hello, so hello. So let's see, let's put this thing together. Yeah. Anointing paste. Apparently shift clicking stuff is not working. So then just doing myself. 1 snowball, 1 belladonna, 1 water artichoke, 1 mandrake. Really? Recipe not working again? Never mind. I just derp up the recipe. It's working! Woohoo! So let's see. The Witch's Cauldron is created by using anointing paste on a cauldron in the world. Yay for the Feed the Beast wiki. So let's put this right here, and... Woo! Oh hey, you get the book for free when you make it. So that's awesome. Wait, which book is this? That's the one that I already made. Derp, never mind. It did make like a fancy... Did-did-in sound. Wow. So is there any guide for this thing? In order to operate this block, requires a couple of things. A roaring fire underneath it, and it needs to be full of water. Up to 3 buckets worth for a maximum. Oh, Swans, you know your way around witchery, apparently, then? I fake it? Okay, cool. Yeah, it's been a while since I actually messed with witchery. Like, 1.5 years or so. So, a lot of stuff has changed. Oh, yeah, summoning demons. Nah, that will be a long time before I'm at that stage, summoning demons. I mean, I can summon you, Deldor. Does that count? You, Deldor, come over here. No, just kidding.
Have you showed our skins?
Oh no, I forgot about that.
Yeah.
Where did you go?
I'm down the mine.
Okay. Then I will just... Next time you're up here, we'll show you them.
Finding diamonds?
Ooh. That makes it a lot better. You finding diamonds.
Well, I just found some ore here. We'll see.
Oh. Ooh. Ah. I just broke stuff. Why did I break
3
stuff?
Diamonds! Oh, 4 diamonds.
I broke stuff. I need to stop breaking.
You can't.
I always break stuff.
Yeah, it's what you've been doing since you started playing Minecraft.
And I'm lighting our fence on fire.
See? Breaking stuff again.
Can I break this Witch's Cauldron? I can.
You can break everything, come on.
Yeah, and apparently light everything on fire too. Okay. No worries, there's a little hole in our fence, but the rest is okay.
Little hole?
Yeah, like one block is missing.
Okay.
So then I will move this thing just to be a little bit further. Ta-da! And let me get a fence, otherwise monsters will spawn because it's getting nighttime and yeah, not fun. So let's see, I need to fill it up with 3 buckets. Okay, cool, Swans, thanks. We need 2 people sleeping though. Because we were 3 people on the server, so. So let's see.
Well, I can't sleep.
Then I will quickly sleep and we will be right back. Alrighty. So, let's see. Now I got myself this Witcher Squadron all set up and ready to go. I want to make the Mutandis, which requires a Mandrake Root, Exile of the Horned One, which we just made in that Witch's Oven, and an egg. So, luckily I got 2 of each right now set up, so I think it's just a matter of throwing them in. Swans, is that right? Can you confirm my suspicions? Awesome. I don't... In the correct order. Oh, okay. Thank you for telling me, because otherwise I wouldn't have done that. So, Mandrake Root, Exile of the Horned One, Egg. I believe that's the order. And then, should something happen, or... I see things spinning. Woohoo, Mutandis! Awesome! That works. So, let me quickly do this recipe once more and see if we can get some of the things that I need to get with the Mutandis. So, last time I checked, Mutandis is that little material that allows you to transmute plant-like stuff. Yes, I said plant-like stuff. Probably you will see what I mean in a second. So, let's see. Witch's Cauldron make fancy particles. Mutandis! Phew, thanks, Swans. So, let's see. Poppy, right click. Grass. Nah. Fern. No. Mushroom. Do we need a mushroom? Might as well take the mushroom. Oh, okay, if we have the mushroom.
I don't think we need a mushroom.
Okay, then I'll transmute the mushroom. Jungle sapling.
Go ahead.
Actually, let's keep the jungle sapling. Might be useful.
Never know.
Another jungle sapling.
Uh-oh.
We don't need to. Grass. Spanish moss. I believe you need a chisel for that. Oh, yeah, I know. Can I use a chainsaw? Oh, okay. Sorry. Calm down. Sorry. No. Calm down. No need to hurry. I know we need Spanish moss. I mean... The name said something witchery for me. So, you get that. And I will get myself another flower to transmute. So, as I already said to your elders once, I'm really trying to... Or, trying. I'm really turning into the surface witch kind of person right now. Doing both Britannia, Towncraft, and witchery. All I need is blood magic and I'm good to go.
Yeah. Doing all the magic.
Yeah, precisely. Mushroom. I can just use a sapling. So. Well, I made a lot of blood. That's a totally different kind of blood magic. You derp. Spruce sapling. Mushroom. Oak. Jungle. Alder sapling. That is something I need, an alder sapling. I know that. So let's see, what did I need for what I wanted to make? I need Whiff of Magic, which required a Rowan sapling. And this is exactly the one that I don't have. So,
of course.
Yeah, let me see what I can do now. Alright guys, so thanks to a lot more Mutandis, I managed to get myself all these saplings that I needed, and even there's a couple of other special things like this Spanish moss. So, that's pretty cool. Currently got that growing. Also, while I was, spawning a couple of these tree saplings that I got just to get more saplings, a couple of ants spawned, like those, living tree thingies. So, I managed to kill them and got myself 2 ant twigs. So, not really something I can do with them just yet, but I'm sure I will be able to use them later. And also, while exploring Udeldor, which sadly had to leave, found himself a portal gun. So he was like, yeah, I had to go anywhere right now, so you can keep on, you can keep it for now. So, that's awesome. Got myself a portal gun. Woohoo! Haha, so awesome. So let's see, what I needed to make was the Whiff of Magic, which required the Rowan saplings, I believe. Yes, it did. So let's see, got myself a bunch of this wood ash that I don't need. Let's burn 7 out of these 8 saplings and place down another Rowan sapling. Get my watering can out while that stuff is being, you know, cooked up into the fumes. I'll be able to quickly grow a couple more of these trees, hopefully, if it doesn't take too long. And eat some bread. Usually it doesn't take that long with the watering can because it speeds up the growth of crops quite a bit. And especially for these kind of crops, it's really useful to have. So, there we go. Sawmill. There we go. I'm not sure what makes... Yeah, I have a watering can, yeah. So, I'm not sure what's required to make ants spawn. But, I can see. The last time I did it, it was both times on a Rowan sapling, so I'm not sure if there's like a guaranteed chance or something. Oh, just stop chopping witchery wood in general, or... Alright. Then I just had the luck of having that with a, what's it called? A, Rowan sapling twice in a row. So. Okay, apparently none spawned, but I think this should be enough. Did I get any of those fumes? I did! 2 whiffs of magic. So, with that, I will be able to create myself an attuned stone. With this attuned stone, I will be able to create a blood altar with a bit of Thumbcraft research too, because I need an alchemical furnace. And then we can finally get going on the evilness that is blood magic. Because I'm not sure who said he would like to do blood magic. But, I mean, technically I could do it too, but what's the fun of me doing all 4 magic mods at the same time? Actually, I guess it could be fun, just a lot of switching around, but yeah, no need for it, probably. So, yeah, pretty cool. So, with that, guys, I think we'll be wrapping up this episode right here. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed. And, oh, yeah, I now have a walrus hat on my head, so. Pretty cool. And also, like I already mentioned, to get myself into the Christmas spirit, I switched to my Christmas skin. So, definitely looking pretty cool. Been using this one for the last 2 years or so already, but you know, never gets old. So like always, if you have any questions, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. And if you have any feedback, feel free to let me know with the thumbs up, thumbs down button, or like always, if you're feeling somewhere complicated like that, the little text button below. For more information, be sure to check out my website to stay up to date with my blogs and all other general information about me. So thanks for watching, leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.